Let's go to Nigeria. Good evening, Patrick. You're most welcome to Straight Talk Africa.
Good evening, Mr. Shaka. Good evening, our guest in the studio.
Terrific. How are you today?
So. That's a crowd for Patrick here in Arutuku, Nigeria. I want to find out from our guest. You see, how do one assess as a small-scale entrepreneur? Because many potential entrepreneurs does not have that capacity that serves as collateral security for soft loans. Now, look at Nigeria as our guest knows very well. Items like tomatoes, onions, salad items are only cheap during the season. Now, after the season, these farmers, they have a lot of problems on how to preserve this, even the consumers. How do we solve? Because I so enjoy this Jumia shopping, right? The way they deliver their things makes super. But the question is the cost for one to patronize the organization is always a problem. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Kunle?
A good question there. I know over here what they're trying to do is when they have, the season for any produce, they basically produce them in a large quantity, mm-hmm. and also preserve them. I know, of course, back home, it's so hard to do that, because of electricity and all those different things, that is holding you back, holding a lot of, entrepreneurs back, from doing those things. What I would say really is to just try as much as possible to make use of what you have. If it's that, in a season, when we have tomatoes, like you said, what can I do to make it actually in a larger quantity, mm-hmm. and preserve just maybe like 50% of that? I know it's going to be hard, it's going to be tough, but just to make something big out of something small, out of your small resources. I mean, that's what I would encourage. Trying to push more and not focus so much on the challenges that you have, even though they're there. And that's what I've been able to do, with my own business. I know when I started, this customization and printing business, I was looking to get a bigger machine to print in bulk, quantity. Mm-hmm. But I decided to start small and say, you know what, instead of me having running around to go look for capital, mm-hmm. here and there and driving myself crazy and not even, wanting to go with the idea, I started with the little that I had. So, getting a small machine.
So is it like the moral equivalent of saying that you go to war with the army that you have?
Exactly.
Rather than the one that you wish you had?
Basically, because what I found out was that by me doing that, I have more knowledge about what I do. Because if I had gotten, a bigger machine that would print, this shirts or this customized shirts, it would have been so hard for me to be able to understand what I have now after 8 years.
I see. Let's go to East Africa. Good evening, Samuel from Uganda. You're most welcome to Straight Talk Africa.
Good evening, Ndugu Shaka. How are you?
I am usually terrific, Ndugu Sam. How are you today?
I'm very fine. Thank you for bringing in Paul Ndiho. My friend Paul Ndiho, Shaka Sally will give you my CV so that we can interact after the show or in the future. Now, I go to Paul Ndiho. How can the European and U.S. markets help African entrepreneurs to market and sell their products? What contingency plans are to be put into place to ensure that the European and U.S. governments can actively give some tax relief and exemption on the exports to the international market so that they can promote international trade? Thank you, Shaka, and thank you, Paul Ndiho, and the host.
Thank you, Samuel, for that great question. I don't know if you are aware or if you've heard of what they call AGOA. The Africa Growth and Opportunity Act, something that was started by President Bush that allows Africans to export, actually to bring their merchandise here in the United States. That's one area that I will tell you maybe to look at and maybe figure out how you can. I know they have an office in Kampala. You can, if you want contacts, I can help you reach out to those people and maybe they can help you. The other thing that personally, I would not, that I would advise you to do is to look at your own market. There is potential in Africa. There is a lot of potential in Africa. Instead of looking at the European or the American market, I think if you started just by tapping into the market around you, I think you'd do a much better job than trying to tap into the American market here.
Thank you. Let's go to Tanzania. Good evening, Tanzania. You're most welcome to Straight Talk Africa. I do not see the name.
Oh, thank you, Shaka. My name is John Silayo. I'm calling from Tanzania.
Thank you very much, Ndugu John. Your question?
I don't have a question, but rather I would like to comment a little bit on how entrepreneurship can be spread among African continents and successfulness of it.
One minute, Ndugu John. 1 minute, please.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Yes, in fact, I was just trying to look at the topic and trying to analyze on how entrepreneurship is being learned in African continent, that sometimes it is being done mostly on the tertiary education. But if we want to have more entrepreneurs and people who are committed to entrepreneurship, maybe things can be started from the scratch. For example, if someone is being developed from the young stage to become an entrepreneurship, if, for example, look at people like Japanese, they are trying to do things from the scratch, but we are trying to do things at the secondary age. So if that thing is being done exactly in a young age, which means we have more people who are committed into entrepreneurship, and then later on we have people who are committed and do something which can make our continent more of a triad. So what I think is that even the government policies, they must make sure that what they are going to develop in their constitutions, sometimes when they are going to discuss things in the parliamentary issues, they must think about it.
Thank you.
That knowledge when they are young.
Thank you, John.
Thank you, Shaka. I have my comments.
Thank you so much, Ndugu John.